So digging through the ability to find things quickly within Kentik, we typically start here in the dashboard section, which is where people go to see things they want to see on an ongoing basis. And as we're looking at things like this, if we see something like this big spike in traffic here and want to go look at that, and this is simple for us as just clicking onto this link, which will then put us into the Data Explorer, which is where we do all the ad hoc queries. And from here, really all we know at this point is that we've got an increase in packets per second, and we know what the destination IP is, and we also know what the port and protocol are. So as we're looking through that, if perhaps this is an FTP server, and maybe we expect the FTP traffic to be there, but if we see something like this UDP 53 traffic should not be there, and we want to dig into that, this is just a matter of filtering down to that traffic, and then adding in more dimensions. And just to demonstrate how quickly we can do that, I'll go ahead and put us on the clock here. And so if I want to just look at the UDP 53 traffic, I can just hit this include button, and then my filters here automatically update. And then if I run the query, we see that the information gets returned within seconds. Now, from here, I'm looking at the last hour. And if we look at the graph here, we basically have zero packets of UDP 53 coming into this IP address, and then we have this big spike, and then it drops down to almost nothing again. So at this point, if I want to go ahead and then focus only on the spike, I can simply highlight that, and now instead of looking at the last hour, I'm looking at literally an 8-minute period here. And where this becomes really powerful is not only did I do all that quickly, but I got down to a very specific time period here. So if folks are trying to correlate this data with things like packet captures or logs that may be out there, they now know exactly where to look. So now that we have this, let's add in the relevant information. And I'd probably want to know what interface this came into my network on. I'd want to know which IPs this traffic actually came from. The things like the source country is always interesting. And let's go ahead and add in the source AS as well, just so if we have to notify somebody that there's some odd traffic coming out of their network, we can do that quickly. So if I go ahead and put all that together, even though we've added in four more things, we still get the information back quickly. And what we find out here is that this is actually coming from a bunch of IP addresses, the GeoIP back to Russia. There was also a Russian telecom involved as the source, which makes sense. And then this came in my GIGI interfaces and then went to this .1 address, and it was all UDP 53 traffic. The problem I typically have here is that this table gives me a lot of good information, but we have a picture here that's a little bit harder to read. So very quickly, we can go ahead and reformat that into something much friendlier to the human eye. And let's go ahead and turn this into a Sankey at this point. And now we have a picture and a key that are much easier to read. At this point, if I want to go ahead and share this out with a team, I can go ahead and do that quickly just via this URL. And once people click on this, they're going to get to the same query that we just ran, and they can play with it and analyze it as needed. And if this is so interesting that we want to send this someplace else for further analysis, anything we do here in the Kentik portal can be accessed, or excuse me, anything we do here in the Data Explorer can be accessed via the API. And we actually help with the API call as well. And for this particular data set, this is what the API call would look like in curl. So once we get this far and we put our heads together to figure out what kind of action we want to take here, we know the destination IP address. So if we wanted to, you can automatically have a remotely triggered black hole sent in, or black hole route, I should say, sent in from Kentik, and have this mitigated automatically. If that was too big of a hammer, then you know the incoming interfaces. We also know the destination IP address and the destination port, which then gives us the ability to go ahead and write a filter against these incoming interfaces that says anything going to this dot one address, that's UDP 53, go ahead and drop it, but let everything else through. In a past life running networks with the tools that I had, this could take me up to 40 minutes just to even get this far. And in our case, we've gone ahead and figured out what type of action we want to take, as well as what caused the traffic increase, in a little under 5 minutes today.